Hey everybody, it's Brenda Edelman. How are you? Damn, I was hoping to do some show and tell with you today, and I don't have my postcards here, and I don't have my painting here, but it's okay. I'll come back with the show and tell. I wanted to check in because it's been a whirlwind of a month, and I wanted to tell you about all the live performances I did, give you some behind the scenes for those of you who want to be speaking, want to be sharing your message, want to be performing. And I wanted to tell you about, I wanted to give you some tips and things like that, okay? Hope that sounds good to you. I'm going to try to make this short. I just have a few minutes here and I wanted to jump on because it feels like it's been a long time. So February was pretty darn incredible. I performed my one-woman show, My Brooklyn Hamlet. That's my stage show where I play about 12 different characters in the full-length version of it. I performed a half an hour of it, four Saturdays in Long Beach at a wonderful theater called the Aurora Theater as part of three divas called Divas in Danger, Escape, Betrayal, and Budget Plastic Surgery. Wow. Yes, that's what it's about. All of us three divas have been in danger and made it through to the other side. An evening of comedy, music, tragedy, and transcendence, really. So anyway, that's pretty exciting, and we sold out each performance. It was a beautiful, intimate theater, but we sold out, and so we extended it for 3 months, just one weekend a month, the third Saturday of each month at the Aurora Theater at 8 p.m. Really excited about that, and I also did... I spoke on my sacred story method. I am back again. I spoke on my sacred story method at Neto Pimentos. I'm messing up his last name. DePaulo. All right, I'm going to write it down. At his branding event, which was amazing. So I went up to LA for that. I spoke on my really four-step sacred story method. Like, how do you share your story in a way when it's tragic, when you've lived through something incredibly severe? How do you talk about it in such a way? How do you share it so that you heal from it at the depth of your being and you actually activate members in your audience to also transform, transcend, see things a different way, have insights? So I did that. I did 15 minutes of my show and I did a 15-minute presentation and then a Q&A in LA. Hey, I see somebody's there. So that was really incredible. I also did a VIP day in another city with one of my clients who has a one-woman show who, since we developed the show together and I directed her show all virtually because she lives in another state, this was my first time I got to meet her, which was so fantastic to work with her overnight. She got her show together within 3 to 6 months, and then she's performed in 2 countries so far, and I think like maybe 13 different places. I don't know how many states it is, or 15 places. Like, it's pretty incredible. I have a joke that it's like I have to keep up with my clients now because they're performing in so many places. So that's kind of cool. And working with my clients, and you know, another client who has been presenting her speaking presentation and got invited to do 8 more. And then my client Sean, who is, I'm getting to finally meet in person on Thursday for VIP day. I'm so excited. I can do everything through online. It's pretty amazing, but I don't think there's anything like meeting in person. I really don't. I also went to several in-person events that were wonderful, like with the Women Speakers Association. Gail, shout out to you. That was incredible. I met wonderful women there. And I was a guest expert on 2 telesummits. Fabulous. I might have to list this stuff. And what I wanted to say as far as tips for behind the scene is that, and the summits were also video summits, right? So it's about how do you be yourself on video? How do you be your best self? How do you answer questions in the moment, listen really carefully, and also get your points across? How do you not get shaken? With the telesummits, there was nothing for me to get shaken about, but I get interviewed a lot, you know, and I've been interviewed for publications, I've been interviewed for radio shows, and sometimes if they don't do their homework, they don't realize that I am all about revealing secrets, that you're ready to reveal, you know, family secrets, and so that the unhealthy behaviors don't continue and things like that. So, yes. So anyway, I teach all of that stuff, and it was interesting this month because I was traveling a lot to different cities to do my presentations, and what I had mentioned to one of my friends is that I wasn't drained at all because I was on purpose. I was on purpose. So I guess what I want to leave you with today, and I know the internet is kind of fakakta right now, so I don't know how much longer it's going to last, but is think about what you want. Think about what your message is. If you don't know what your message is because you've lived through so much, I can help you kind of narrow in on which story that you want to. You know what I'm going to do? I have a free webinar that I've done before. I haven't led it for a long time, so watch here because I'm going to put something together and I'm going to do a free webinar because there'll be an exercise on there to help you figure out which story to tell or which to focus on first, right? So there's that, and then now I lost my train of thought. Well, I'm gonna because I wasn't expecting that I'm gonna do that webinar. Okay, so I'm going to get off and create that webinar and set it up, and then invite you guys. I'll put it in the link underneath here. But all I want to say is I wasn't drained because I was on purpose. I wasn't drained because I share a very, some people would call tragic story, but it's no longer a tragic story because I learned the lessons and I got to the other side. And so I share from that place of empowerment. But I also don't save people from going on the ride with me up until the point where I learned to forgive. I learned to let go. Oh, there was something really cool. There was this woman who came to our show, Divas in Danger, the first night, and then she came back and brought five people the last night of the February run. That was super cool. That the show was so amazing. Oh, and then I'm performing in a wonderful event with the Women's Journey, excuse me, Foundation, and I'm going to be playing Eleanor Roosevelt in an event called Her Story, because a lot of women haven't really made it into the history books, and that's what this is about. We have other amazing women, people being played from the past as well. That's on, I think, March 10th. I think March 10th. And then we're performing again, Divas in Danger, on March 17th in the Aurora Theater. The other thing I wanted to say, so check back here. Let me know if you've seen this, if you've watched the replay. And if you're going to come to the webinar, that'd be really cool because in the webinar, I'm going to give you the foundational exercise that I give to all of my clients on how to find the story to focus on first so that you're not wasting a lot of time. And also, specifically, if you're an entrepreneur, how to find the right story that's going to be in service to your business, right? How cool would that be? And if you want more information, I'm going to drop a link for for my membership site too. Might as well put it there because what I want to do is help you. I don't want to just leave you stranded and say, here, try a little of this, and that's it, right? If you actually want more help, you want to talk to me, message me and let me know. So I feel like I have a little space because now I'm not doing a show a week in another city, so I want to just make myself available, okay? Have a fantastic day, Brenda Edelman. Ciao.